Hello, everybody. Welcome to your weekly celebrity reading this week. It is Kristen Stewart. This is a, like I do with all my celebrity readings, they're based on subscriber requests. Kristen Stewart was requested a couple times. I'm finally getting around to her. And if you are a subscriber, definitely leave some requests for celebrities you want me to read. I'll add them to my list. And if you're fans of Kristen Stewart, leave comments as well. Listen, so the one thing I do, I only pull up their birth chart just to give you an idea of who they are, why they are the way they are, what we can see for them. And this is just, I'll spend like 20 seconds, maybe a minute talking about it. And the other thing is I don't Google them. I don't like to know what's going on in their life. The reason is because I like to do cold readings, all right? It's fun for me. Now, I do a reading for every sign, a weekly reading, and then monthly readings every month. And so these celebrity readings are just really fun for me to do. The reason I do cold readings is because you should never be biased in your reading when you have an emotional attachment, or, you know, with any of the celebrities you're reading, or if you know a lot about what's going on in their life right now, you can, tarot readers can like subconsciously like maybe try to like interpret the cards in a way that's like favorable, but nope, not for me. I'm just gonna read it as it is. So here's the thing about Kristen Stewart. She is an Aries. Her rising is in Gemini. Like, this is first of all, we know Jupiter is in Aries. It actually dipped back into Pisces for just a little bit until the end of December, but back in Aries until May 2023. What does this mean? This means that this is the best year that Kristen Stewart will have in the past 12 years. So think about what happened for her 12 years ago, okay? She's going to have a really great year, and I won't be surprised if we hear a lot from her, okay? Or if she wins big awards, I will not be surprised. This is a big, big year for her, all right? And then also with all that activity in Gemini, as her rising sign, I'm not really going to focus on that. That is more of, you know, she's spending a lot of time with like her friends right now and her network, and that's really good for her. But it's also the house of hopes and dreams. Jupiter's there too. So again, I think that there's a lot that we're going to see from her. Now, the eclipses that we're going through right now, they're probably going to, you know, she's in Aries and rising Gemini, so, you know, these eclipses really do affect the fixed signs most, but we could see some activity with her, she could find some activity with her finances, okay, and also she may be going pretty deep. There may be some soul searching she's doing coming up in November. Okay. Last thing I want to say is that her Venus is in her 10th house in Pisces. Oh my goodness. She is, listen, of course she was born to have a lot of attention. She probably even loves it, right? But let's go ahead and get started with her reading for what's going on just with all these energies, with her energy right now. And also the last thing I was going to say is she does have a stellium in Capricorn. Okay. So we know that she works really hard and that is her thing. She is a, she prioritizes, there's a part of her that really just prioritizes work. It's really important to her. Now, so Kristen Stewart, what's going on with you right now? Well, it looks like she is going through some stuff. Wow. Okay. She may be, going through a process, okay? Listen, here's the thing. She did get the Three of Cups, which I love, okay? This is, you know, celebration, but, you know, the deeper meaning here, honestly, it's bonding, okay? It's sisterhood, it's brotherhood, it's getting together with your friends, it's, you know, Three is all about growth and advancement, but also creation, okay? So this is when you get together with friends, family, when you celebrate, when you have fun. It's almost like, you know, it's the birth of new ideas. You talk about things and, you know, there's that energy flow and everything's just great. You know, other than just that bonding, you know, which raises our oxytocin levels, right? To a whole other level. it's just really good to be in that moment. Now, things have been good for her. She's been spending time with her friends. And, you know, like I said, that is a big thing with Jupiter and Aries in her 11th house, okay? Now, where does that bring us? It brings us to the Three of Swords. So, this came in the heart of her spread. And as we know, this is the card of grief and heartbreak and loss. So there may be something that she's going through right now. It could even be like a breakup that she's thinking about. There could be something that is definitely not great. I mean, as you can see, that is an enlarged heart, okay? Now listen, even though it is the card of heartache, right? And grief and loss, it's still a sword suit, right? Swords are the mental suit, okay? So what's happening here is coming up here. And so it's something that she needs to face at this point. She did get the Two of Swords, okay? In her challenge area. Now, you can see the woman blindfolded. She's in front of the ocean. The water represents emotions, but there's that sliver of moonlight you see in the corner. She needs to trust her intuition. There's something Kristen doesn't want to face right now. That she's lying to herself about something, or it's just something that this, whatever emotional process she's going through right now is really, really affecting her mental health, okay? And so she really needs to process this. She really needs to take off that blindfold. She really needs to, you know, make a decision, not only to take off that blindfold, but there could be a decision that she has to make, okay? There could be something that is holding her back. Now, she also got the Tower in her crown, okay? This is the card of chaos and destruction, and you know, it is she's thinking about there was something that happened that was pretty unexpected, okay? And it probably really shocked her. It really brought her to this point. And again, this is pointing to, you know, she got the Four of Wands, okay? So listen, the energy that's coming through, first of all, she needs to get over it. And I know it's easier said than done, but when you have the Tower moment in your crown, this is, and then when you have the Three of Swords in the heart of your spread and the Two of Swords in the challenge area, there's a lot going through her head right now, all right? Things that may not be favorable for her, all right? Some things that are, I would say, even like haunting her a little bit, okay? A lot of it could have to do with relationships. It could be something that in her personal life with home as well. But, you know, I think that once she gets out of it, it's something that's really affecting her reaching this moment of celebration of, it's almost like it's blocked her from this milestone she's supposed to reach, okay? Not only, remember, she got the Three of Cups celebration, she also got the Four of Wands in her crown, okay? That's also like a sense of celebration there, reaching a milestone, like just a very pure, good, happy card. So, I think she really needs to spend some time processing a lot of these things. She needs to figure out how to move forward from it. It looks like it is pretty intense. I mean, the fact that she did get the Two of Swords, the Three of Swords, and the Tower. Now, she did get the Six of Cups, okay? So it really is, again, like there's something that has to do with friends or in her network, okay? But, you know, at the end of the day, the main message that's coming through is that she really needs to... she's aware, obviously, of what's happened here. And all she really wants right now is like comfort and security, okay? One thing that I think that she needs to do is go back and think about some people from her past. Think about moments of her past that really brought her joy, all right? Just that feeling of nostalgia. Now, nostalgia it improves well-being, okay? It improves our quality of life. It improves mental health, okay? This is not my opinion, by the way. This is data. This is Harvard. This is Stanford. This is all the studies done, all right? And this is a major card of nostalgia, all right? But it is security and comfort here as well. I think that all she wants to do is just really just, it's almost like she wants to not be serious in the moment right now. She just wants to have fun. But then there's this something that's really like impacted her emotionally, and now it's going up there. Okay, now she did get the Two of Wands in her future, so it looks like she needs to just process things right now. Okay, she needs to process things, and if there's anything, you know, and especially with her passions, okay, that's going to really help her if she just kind of plans things out. She obviously sees the milestones she wants to reach. She obviously sees, she has a vision. She sees her goal. She sees what's out there, right? Really good perspective, but she needs to process all this. Now, here is the good news. And here, look who comes in to save the day. She did get the Wheel of Fortune, the card of good luck and prosperity. And I mean, this is ruled, you know, it's ruled by Jupiter, all right? The Wheel of Fortune is ruled by Jupiter. And so it is in her future area. There is going to be a moment of divine intervention here. There is going to be a moment where, you know, there's it's just luck putting her on the path of faith that she belongs, right? And so she really does have to do some processing first, but she does have luck on her side. Okay, this is a major card. I mean, I feel a lot of these energies are gonna, it's because of these eclipses, they're game changing, right? But you can see the four fixed signs in the Taurus and Scorpio eclipses are fixed signs, and you see the four fixed signs in the corners of the universe. They're all reading the Book of Knowledge, the Book of Wisdom. Listen, this is honestly, she will be in a good place. She will get out of this. She has to go at her own pace, at her own comfort level, and I don't want her to rush through anything, but I want her to know she'll be fine, she's protected, and she will be back on the path that she belongs on, all right? But there is definitely something that is happening personally, and she's going to have to process a little bit of that right now, especially with, you know, the Tower in her crown and then all these swords. But she just needs to dig deep and think about those moments in the past that brought her joy and just really raise her energy level. So we are going to get to her staff now. So let's see what's going on here. She's fine. She's going through a moment, and again, I'm not surprised with these eclipses. Even, you know, they're game-changing. They're big. Let's get to it. She did get the Hanged Man, okay? This is really good, and it looks like what she's going to do and what she needs to do is embrace this new, all right? Some stuff is happening here, and it's almost like a message saying whatever this is that's really affecting you emotionally, and it's affecting your mental health and your headspace, burn it down, build it up, okay? The Hanged Man, as you can see, hanging upside down. Now, the reason why is because the things that he was so used to in the past stop working, all right? It's almost, you have to have a new perspective moving forward, okay? And in order to do that, you need to really let something go. You need to surrender something. You actually have to make some sort of sacrifice, all right? You can see the halo around his head. You can see the smile on his face. He actually put himself here, okay? Because he knew that he needed to look at things in a different way. This is Kristen right now. She is, this is what she wants. She wants to look at things in a different way. And it feels, there is that feeling of like, I need to do something new. I'm just kind of like, you know, my everything in my life right now, just get something new, right? Just do something new. I remember Venus is in their 10th house, but also, you know, in Pisces. And so I love that energy. And that is, you know, Pisces are so imaginative, and they're so compassionate, and they're so I love Pisces. Now listen, she did get the Page of Wands. Great, love it, okay? Definitely something coming through, a new sort of passion, okay? The Pages are the newbies in the Royal Court, okay? But they have so much power in the Minor Arcanas, under the Aces. They usher in the most new change, and they are the newbies, so they bring in that new energy. She is going to get some sort of message, too. Something maybe about a new role or about a new opportunity. It's coming through, okay? But she is going to... there is, it's, you know, like I said, she has all that Capricorn in her, you know, the stellium in Capricorn, and she is going to be working really hard. And so this is something that we can expect from her. There's going to be something that really compels her, something new, and she's going to just boom, boom, boom. I love this. I'm going to put all my heart, body, you know, blood, sweat, tears, mind, body, soul into it. And I love that. All right. So expect something new. And again, she may get some sort of message about a new role or new something that's coming up career-wise for sure. She did get the Magician. Like I said earlier, she wants this new journey. She wants something new, okay? The Magician is, you know, it kicks off the trump cards, the journey. Has the power to manifest whatever he wants, you know? He has all the tools at his disposal here, okay? And again, and when I say tools, it is the Cups, it is the Pentacles, it is the Wands, it is the Swords. You see his hand to the sky, hand to the earth, as above, so below, bringing all of your dreams and hopes and manifestations into your reality right now. The Magician is an active card, though. You have to put action toward it. It doesn't, and of course I am getting the energy, she will, okay? She wants to move past this, but she wants this new perspective. She has this new opportunity coming through, and she wants to start this new journey. Now, final outcome, how amazing, all right? The Nine of Pentacles. I call this, you know, she's kind of like the movie star of tarot, right? She's just so glamorous, all right? Now you see her gown is covered with the symbol of Venus, okay? And so I love that energy for her. This is all about abundance. This is financial success. This is freedom. This is that independence that we look for. Now listen, this is her final outcome, okay? So all those things that she desires, she's going to have a lot of abundance. Now, Venus is a planet of love and career and money. And, you know, it's abundance. And you can see the harvest around her. You can see, you know, everything. Even the falcon on her hand. Listen, who holds a falcon on their hand, right? Only the people in the royal court. Horus is the falcon here, all right? There's a lot of spiritual alignment with this process, but in the end, she's going to be fine. She's going to be fine, and she's actually going to get something pretty huge. Listen, she also got the Six of Pentacles as a clarifier. Listen, six is the heart of the tree of life. Six is, you know, harmony, all right? And this is just a very altruistic card. So when this comes up in the final outcome, the main message that's coming through for me is she is going to share the wealth, something for her fans, okay? So again, it could be a new she could be doing something like a new movie, a new project. There is some, you know, wealth being shared. You can see that he's helping others in this card, and you know, that's something that will bring some balance into her life. I think that, you know, I don't know, I'm not a celebrity, I don't know how it works, but you know, I think that in some sense they like to please their fans, right? And so I think that this is, you know, especially with the Nine of Pentacles here, she got two pentacles, but I did say that Jupiter is in Aries up until May 2023. It's in Pisces for a little bit right now, which is fine. And again, like I said, she's going to be in her head a little bit, all right? Especially because Jupiter in Aries, Jupiter in Pisces for, you know, the next few weeks, up until the end of the year, that is her 12th house, okay? That is her 12th house. And then we know that eclipse that's happening in Taurus next November 8th is her 12th house. She's going to be in her head a lot. But in the end, she's fine. She's golden. She's fine. I mean, the fact that she got the Wheel of Fortune in her future, the Page of Wands here. I mean, she got all these major arcanas. Right now, though, she is going through a process where things are, you know, a little emotional for her, and it could be pretty intense, actually. All right? She's going to have to just get clear her mind, okay? She's gonna have to process all this, and then she'll be fine moving forward. I mean, her stuff is just come on, this is great for her. The final outcome with all those pentacles, so we'll see a lot of money with it too. And when I say money, you know, pentacles are money and wealth, but they're also tangible reality, physical reality. So again, I think she's going to come out with some sort of new role, or something's going to happen where her friends or fans are really happy. She's going to give some of that as well. But wealth, again, also, when I talk about wealth, especially here, wealth in all areas of her life, she's going to feel it. She's going to, you know, she really worked hard to get to the point where she's at, as indicated with the Knight of Pentacles. So that said, that is the reading for Kristen Stewart. Thanks again for tuning in. If you have a celebrity you want me to read, drop them in the comments. And if leave comments and let me know if any of this resonates. And if you're new to my channel, it would be great if you like and subscribe. I do a reading for every sign, every week, monthly readings and celebrity reading. All right, thank you so much. Really appreciate it. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.